So, good afternoon and welcome to this presentation entitled Live Trade with a Trading Central Alpha Generation. Please find here our contact details, drop an email to fx@swissquote.com if you need further information about our trading services or visit our website swissquote.com. What do you need to trade Forex? Of course, a trading account with our platform, but please remember, if you want to use Trading Central plugin, you need to have the MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5 platform. So if you are not our customer yet, you need to open a live or demo account from our website, swissquote.com. Please be reminded that the Trading Central plugin works on live accounts only with a minimum equity of 1,000 Swiss francs or equivalent. Trading Central daily analysis and plugin are free of charge for Swissquote customers. If you are already a Swissquote customer, but you don't have a MetaTrader account, you can easily open it in a few minutes thanks to our smart sign up. You can find here our global presence. We have offices in Switzerland, Luxembourg, London, Malta, Dubai, Hong Kong, and Singapore. A special welcome to Gary Christie, head of North American Research at Trading Central. How are you today, Gary?
Hello. Yeah, thank you, Stefan. I'm doing great. Thank you very much. How is you today?
Yeah, all perfect. So we also start the session now. So I'm very glad and very happy. We also have positive feedback from our customer, like Andrei. So after the previous webinar, then he had a successful experience, so we go ahead with our educational series. Also, thank to you, Gary.
Thank you very much. Yes, excellent. All right, well, let's get right into it. So it's a pleasure to be here again. Thank you, Stefano and Swissquote, for inviting me again. I've done a few of these presentations now. And again, I'm sharing my screen now. Let me know if you can't see it for any reason. You know, these days we're all working. Yeah, good, excellent. These days we're all working from home, so you never know with technology. So just let us know if there's a problem in the chat box. And while you're there too in the chat box, I would love to see what everyone trades. So if you don't mind, just put in a quick comment of you know, what do you trade with Swissquote and what's your favorite products. I'm going to go over lots of products today, and this is kind of a fun webinar for me just because I get to play with some live trades and look at the market in real time, and you'll get to see how an analyst such as the ones here at Trading Central view the market from a top-down approach, and how you can use our tools right in Swissquote's and platform on MT4, MT5. And let's just jump right in. So just before we go ahead, I always like to just discuss who we are at Trading Central, what we do. So of course, Trading Central here, we are a leading investment research provider of financial market professionals. Two financial market professionals. Our technical strategies cover equity, index, forex, commodities, and fixed income markets. And well, basically, technical analysis is our core business. Our award-winning methodology is backed by time-tested indicators, and our chartists and mathematical approaches match requirements of various investment styles, from intraday trading to swing trading, long-term investing, and over at least 150 leading financial institutions in over 45 countries do rely on our technical analysis expertise and trading experience. So just a little bit about us before we go. We've been doing this for a long time, as you can see on the slides here. But moving right in, just a little bit about me. So I am the head of Trading Central's North American Research Desk. Our analyst team provides technical analysis and trade recommendations on almost all asset classes to institutions all over the world. So just before I joined Trading Central, I was a trader for TD Bank, where I was an equity options specialist. And I've been an active trader for well over 15 years now, and have been helping fellow traders build disciplined trading plans to help them become more consistently profitable traders. Now, quick disclaimer here today, we're talking about live trades. Of course, this is meant for educational purposes, so don't see this as advice. We're just here to help you, learn the tools and look at the markets from my perspective. But again, this is no way meant to be any kind of advice or solicitation whatsoever. Now, just a little bit about the Trading Central plugin. That's why we're here today, to show you how you can use this and help you in your trading. The Trading Central plugin does give you the unique ability to retrieve Trading Central's analyst research directly on your MT4 or MT5 platform. The plugin includes three items. It's analyst views, adaptive candlesticks, and adaptive divergence convergence indicator, ACDC, we call it. So we will go through some of those today. Now, there is a great video right on YouTube on SwissQuote's site. I encourage you to check it out. That goes into more detail of each indicator and how it works. Feel free to go and read up on that one here. I'm not going to go through all that today's because I want to get right into some live trading and some live analysis. That seems to be the real action here in these presentations and where I could give you the most value. Because markets have been quite volatile these days. So I don't want to waste any more time. I want to jump right into the MT4 platform, and we're going to have a look at some of products that are heavily traded, that are more interesting, that are quite active today. So let me just get out of here quickly. And again, if you have any questions, just let us know right in the chat box as I go on. I usually try to answer them as I go through this presentation. But first off, how do you just grab the indicator pack? Right on SwissQuote's main page, you can click on Forex at the top. And once you are there, you can go ahead and we'll click on and just hover the mouse right over platforms. And then you can see Trading Central. So once you click on Trading Central, you will have a lot more information here as well as the YouTube video on SwissQuote on how to use these indicators or what they actually do. And you can download the pack right here into MT4 once it's installed and you have the platform installed running on MT4 and MT5. You can go ahead and slide these right into the platform, which I'll show you in a minute. So let's just get right into the fun and jump into the platform. Now here is MT4 live account SwissQuote. And I have it set up a particular way, the way I like to see a quick view, real time. And some I have, whatever I use for indicators is not necessarily the best ones you should be using. It's just what my preference is. And if you have questions about those indicators, please let us know in chat. But let's get started with the overall main market. My main indice that I watch, of course, is the S&P 500. So here we are, US 500. I'm just going to open, if you right click, open a new chart window. Here we go. We have a 30-minute chart right now. And as indices were up this morning, it looks like we are pulling back just as the market just opened 8 minutes ago. Quite a drastic move at the open. And just to get a better, broader view, what I always like to do before I decide what I'm going to do intraday trading is look at the longer term view. We do apply a top-down approach to Trading Central. So we don't like to go against the main long-term trend. So here you can see, yes, we have a slight uptrend supported by that yellow line, which is that 200 period moving average on a 30-minute chart. But however, we are selling off right now, right at the open. So let's go dig into a daily chart. And it tells a little different story, right? So long term, we have recovered most of that decline since the coronavirus started and those lows we posted back in March. So what's interesting here is that although we've seen pretty much some devastation in global economies regarding job outlooks and businesses failing and everyone's at home, no one's working, the market's telling a lot different story here. So according to the market, it looks like we may recover quite fast from this coronavirus pandemic. Hard to say, really, no one really knows what's gonna happen with the S&P. All you can do is trade the price action, and the price action doesn't lie, all right? So what we got in front of us here is a massive rebound in the S&P, and we've finally broken above that 200-day moving average in yellow. That is a significant technical event. All right, so what's happening now is we've got a slight consolidation the last 5 days above this to see if we're going to hold above support on the right here, right above that 200-day moving average. So key levels to watch. Well, as a technical analyst, I'm always looking for major areas of support and resistance. And we can see some here. So I'm just going to grab a horizontal line tool on MT4. And really, since we've broken above that 200-day moving average in yellow, that's a significant breakout from this consolidation. Really, the next logical target I'm going to draw on the chart is around the 3130, 3131 area, which is really looking at that March 4th high. And then breaking above there, yeah, we have another gap resistance area, and we're going to draw it right around that February high, 3304, 3305 area. They're not exact, but these are levels you should be watching on a long-term chart. So the bias is definitely bullish here on the S&P, and no denying it, it's been a massive recovery. You could even see that we struggled for some time to break above that 200-day with this consolidation zone right below the chart here. And finally, we broke out of it. And now it's a matter of, do we maintain support? And maybe we ride this red 20-day moving average higher and continue to test those record highs from February, or we break down. And the first signal really here that we cautious us is a close below that 200-day moving average and maybe even a close below that 20-day moving average. So this is in trend following mode right now in the S&P. And really no reason to try to, you know, get short here until we have some confirming signals. For now, nope, we're riding it, we're consolidating, looking for higher price action. And this is a big disconnect from what we see in the news, right? So we've seen, lots of negative news across the world regarding the economy. Yet here we have, you know, what do you do when what should happen doesn't, is what I said in the last presentation we gave here back in April. And really, it is shocking to see the strength of the U.S. equity markets during these times. So, you know, we can wait forever to try to sort this market, but it never happens. It could be a very expensive wait, and you know, it's a challenging time for sure. But for now, pretty clear, we're looking higher. If you break it down short term, back to a 30-minute chart today, which is what we focus on intraday here, clearly we may see a retest down to 3045 area. So generally, if you're a long-term trend follower, you would not try to counter trend this and short it, even though it looks quite bearish. You'd wait for an opportunity to get long. And short term, we can draw a trend line, 30-minute chart, rough area. This is what I'd be watching right now. We get down to the lower end of this trend line. Let me just delete some of these. Every time you want to delete a drawing, you can go ahead, click on objects list, right click on the chart. You can go ahead and delete the rectangles here. I'll do that for you right now. Yeah, rectangle, delete. Doesn't want to do it always for me. There we go. Daily chart. And delete. Maybe not today. That's all right. Short term, it's okay. But really here, intraday, we are riding this trend higher. And I'll just redraw that because we'll wait during the presentation. If you get low to a certain area, it could be an opportunity to try a long entry. But that's the S&P. Really, the big story has been NASDAQ. Here we have it here on the chart. I'm just going to enlarge it for you. And we are within a couple percent of record highs, which is phenomenal in NASDAQ. And here you can see it's fully engaged in a trend mode above its 20-day moving average here in red. So we've tested it multiple times and we keep riding it higher. The question is, do we break record highs now? We should most likely. There's nothing stopping it from getting tested around the 9750 area in red here. But really, huge momentum. We've had now you can call this a golden cross, where we've had the 50-day moving average cross above the 200-day in yellow. And that's a significant bullish event. We had a bearish signal here that did not last very long at all. And now we're recovering. So I just want to show you some of the indicator packs, of course, of what we do for you. All these levels I'm talking about, we do draw them and maintain them every day with our analyst team. We have over 10 analysts globally that are constantly monitoring these markets for you 24 hours a day. And if you want to know what our analysts are thinking, once the pack is installed, you'll see here on the left, you have a Trading Central tab and all our indicators here. And the easiest way to install these on the chart is just to click on analyst views, for example, and drag it right onto the chart. And then hit OK. And here we go. We have Trading Central's main support and resistance and pivot areas. I'm just going to bring them down here so we can see them. You see how I drew that red record high line? Well, we already have it as a target, which is resistance one. And if you put your mouse over the line, it will tell you exactly what that means. Let's say R1 is our first line of resistance, and we have multiple targets ready for you if you do break out of those above those record highs. So how to look at an analyst view picture, really quite simple and easy to understand. The blue line is always our pivot. You can see down here, we also write up a description as to where that pivot is, 91.55. You see it in blue written on the chart, 91.55. That is our point of invalidation. So our preference, you can see the very top is written down, Trading Central preference rise. And our preference does give you below here a description, long positions above 91.55 with targets at 97.23 and 10.300 in extension. You can see those in the green lines here. Now, anytime we close below this level, 91.55, well, we will change our view to bearish right away. So we don't hesitate. That's we maintain strong discipline in our analysis. So as soon as we break below 91.55, we will aim for short positions down to our alternative scenario. So at all times, the idea here is you're getting a bullish or bearish scenario. And in fact, you don't have to exactly be on the same direction as Trading Central's preference. You may be bearish already. Well, all these levels are extremely important, regardless if you're bullish or bearish, right? So we were giving you alternative scenarios for in any direction. And here we can see, yeah, definitely we have support here, you know, right around those February and March highs down here at 8860 and then 8600, right? So these are all major levels that all floor traders or traders around the world are watching. For now, it looks like a steady climb supported by that red line, which is the 20-day moving average onto record highs, and nothing really stopping it. It's going to be very interesting to see what happens once we get to those record highs around the 97.23 area to see if we fail and test the lows, or are we just, you know, off to the races and continue higher. Quite interesting story, but for now, NASDAQ has never looked back since making those March lows. Now you could also jump right into 30-minute charts. And when you do that, when you change the time frame, it will automatically adjust and grab our 30-minute analysis at Trading Central for our pivot levels. So we have a major support level here. I left it at 93.87. We're quite overextended, which makes sense because our main pivot is way below here at 93.87. And you know what? We also have a trend line breakdown, right? So if I draw a rising trend line, we can pretty much draw right up and see the breakdown happen when it broke below that 50 period moving average in blue. All right, so pretty weak. We have support way below us, which means really that we've been overextended for quite some time. If you are short, really quite the opportunity here to maybe grab that 200 period moving average as a target. You can instantly do a quick sell right away. I'll just do one as an example right now. Boom, 95.69, we have a sell in. And what's great about MT4, you can drag up right from your line and drop, and it's instantly creating a stop loss for you. All right, and if you want to create a target, click on the green line where your entry price was and bring it down. This is pretty ambitious, but if you looked at the 200 period moving average, that's a target. There we go. So we have now, in a matter of seconds, an entire scenario built. We had a live trade just done where we're short, you know, the NASDAQ 100 index, and we have a stop loss in place to manage our risk, and we have a target in place to take it. So it's almost autopilot here. These are just based right off of real-time levels. So we'll save that and see how it looks. Anytime you want to see how it's doing, you know, click on the terminal option at the top and you can see your trades in play here. Slightly down about $4 real time. We'll go back to it later on. I'll just close that terminal for now because there's lots of charts to go through. And again, if you have any specific charts, don't hesitate, put them in the question box and I'll have a look at them. Now, let's just minimize this. And let's have a look. What else do we have going on today? So one popular, you know, currency pair that's been active in the last little while has been the US dollar CAD. Let's have a look at it right now. Here we go. I have it in my monitor. I can just double click and we have a large snapshot. Let's go into a daily chart. Quite interesting here. We have a major breakdown in the US dollar versus the CAD. Again, if I want to slide in analyst views, just slide it right in right now. We could get our team's work real time. And makes perfect sense here. We have major resistance at the 1.39 pivot area in blue. And I can see a technical pattern taking place here, right? So first off, we have resistance at 1.41 and 1.43. These are all drawn for you. And these are watched by our team all the time. So anytime we update these levels, it will update MT4, MT5 right away. So some people, I know, get a lot questioned a lot saying, you know, when are these updated? Well, they're updated every time a level has been reached, or at least on a term like this, daily happens at least once a week if nothing's happening with the pair. But every time we touch one of our targets or support resistance levels, we get an alert to update the chart right away. I'm just going to remove these for now so I can dig right in with some trend lines and some fun patterns. So I will click on indicators list, click on analyst views, and just delete it for now. Now, what do we have going on here? So this has been all over the news, big breakdown in the US dollar. What I'm seeing right away, of course, me being a technical analyst, I can see this wedge or triangle or symmetrical triangle breakdown. This is how we draw our major support resistance levels. In analyst views, we consider all patterns. You may not always see them all the time. Of course, we don't have the ability to share our patterns in MT4, but our levels do consider that. So we have right away, bearish crossover, 50 period crosses over the 20 day right here. And we're trending lower. We have a symmetrical triangle breakdown. This is usually an indication of a period of indecision psychologically. This is why these patterns happen and why patterns are so useful, especially classic patterns in technical analysis, because it's giving us the psychology of the marketplace. So we've had a massive rally to highs around the 1.465 area. We've consolidated. We haven't decided where to go from here until recently. We've broken down quite violently and we've been selling off ever since. And we paused right at that 200-day moving average. Now, this is a great example of why certain major moving averages we use all the time in our analysis, because they do react, right? So this is where else do you go when you've been selling off so strong? Traders are going to try to find the next, you know, easy level of support. It's definitely 1.349 area and we're rebounding. But overall, the longer picture is bearish, right, for the US dollar CAD. And that would have been a sweet trade if we got in and as soon as we broke below, we put a stop loss right at that trend line. And if you were wrong, you would have been wrong, not too expensive. But if you're right, like we see here, we've been quite a profitable trade. Now, let's break it down. We'll go into a 30-minute chart. And now it's a little bit mixed, right? We have a declining trend still in play, but we may be trying to break out of it today. Intraday. I'd be cautious on this one for any further downside. We have nice touches here on the declining trend line, a break above that 20 period moving average, right? So if you're a bottom up kind of a trader, we can take action on this one. Let's just do a live trade right now and see if you can get an opportunity towards that 50 period moving average in blue. We can just go ahead, do a quick buy. Wait for that. There we go. We got the sound. We are now long US dollar CAD. Again, this is counter trend to the longer term, but I have to show an example of, you know, how you can react to both directions when there's a unique opportunity. Always put your stop loss in. I'm going to put it near support 1.35 one area. And let's just drag it in a target area where we can see, I would say, near that 50 period moving average. And we can see resistance here right now as well in that area. So this is a riskier setup, doing this by example only here, just for your reference of how to trade a bottom-up kind of strategy. Even though the long-term is down, like we saw on daily, we have a unique opportunity short-term for a possible short-term trade on a breakout. And I love trading off of breakouts or any technical patterns. You got to take advantage of them when you can. And just have good risk management. That's the most important part of trading. It's not so much your entry. It's how you manage it when you're long, knowing when to get out, when to take your profits, and be disciplined about that. And don't be sliding your stop losses down ever, right? Anything, you should be moving up when you're playing a rebound, not the opposite direction. And if you're wrong, you're wrong, so be it. But this is a quick way to manage a trade in a matter of seconds on an opportunity. So that's the US dollar CAD. Again, long-term bearish, short-term, attempting a rebound, which is not, you know, too extreme to say, because we've had such a decline here and we're on daily support, right? So we may even get a technical, you know, a hammer candlestick here, which would be a nice reversal. But for now, you know, we'll play the short-term rebound, and if we're wrong, we're wrong. Well, what also we can do here is add another pack from Trading Central's adaptive indicators, and we can add adaptive candlesticks. And I'll just use this as an example while we're here. Grab it, slide it into the chart. It might take a few seconds to load. And here we go. So now, what we've done at Trading Central, again, you can watch the YouTube video and Swiss Quote site on how these work, but the simple of way to read these is that they are reversal candles, and we use the 16 best technical setups in reversal candles and only apply those to algorithm to identify them for you on the chart. So if you're a candlestick trader, you can use these to try to spot an opportunity. Just putting in your mouse over, it'll tell you what it means. So we have a white long bar larger than average up body. This is a bullish signal. We've had a bunch of them here. So we've had a hammer, bullish event in a downtrend, which is what we're kind of seeing on a daily chart I was just talking about. That's a bullish reversal. We've identified a white long bar and another one. So we've had some bullish momentum, which kind of supports our scenario right now of a possible rebound. And these are done for you automatically, identifying interesting patterns, and they're interesting reversal patterns. So that's how you use adaptive candlesticks. If you like them and use them in your trading, we can identify them for you. And we have reversals here as well. So notice how we've had a three-line strike reversal pattern. We had three bullish candles and a massive engulfing bearish candle right on testing resistance of that declining trend line. That's what we like to see to confirm that this trend line is in fact accurate and in play. So now it's a matter of, do we continue or not? We could totally fail here. But I like to see these reversal candles form right on resistance on a trend line, and we see them forming on a declining moving average. So we have a multiple indicator setup, I would call it here, and a breakout. So it's significant. We don't want to discount this. And if we fail, you know, we have a pretty tight stop to offset that. But that's a lot of work on the US dollar CAD, but this is how we go through the thinking process of trades. So let's move along. And so we had the US dollar CAD, Aussie US dollar was also in play. And we can see that here, massive upside momentum today. So many good opportunities these days. So let's just open up this one. Here we have a daily chart of the Aussie US. And really, we've seen a lot of, you know, resource and materials-based currencies get bid the last few days as we've seen the economy come out of, you know, lockdown. There is some speculation of demand for materials, raw goods. As the economy gets back into production, these currencies have been getting, you know, bid, and, you know, a lot of energy related. We've seen oil recover quite a bit as well. And these are energy tied securities, like the CAD and the Aussie. And no mistaking here, what a move higher we've seen in the last few days. So this is a lot like that S&P chart we're showing you. We're breaking above that 200-day moving average. This is a massive uptrend right from the, we'll call that the coronavirus low in March. You got a higher trend. You have a trend line in place. We have a breakout. Everything's looking bullish, extremely strong, pretty weak for the US dollar as a whole. But right now, you know, we can slide in analyst views. Let's just see what we're seeing right now on the analyst team. And here we go. So we've actually reached our first target today. So our analyst team will update this today. We'll get an alert. As is happening right now, we like to see probably a little bit more time in the day before we update this to see if it's a true breakout. That's a significant target reach, 0.685 on the Aussie US dollar pair. Next step now is we most likely, you know, we're gonna start raising these stop losses up. And in fact, you can actually do them right on the charts. If you were actually to follow them yourself and maybe you wanna use your levels on your own, you can manipulate these levels for your own trading. Keep that in mind. So in any time, again, if you're concerned or not sure what these pivots mean, put your mouse right over it and it'll tell you pivot is our first line of support. So right away, obviously you can see that we have a bullish play happening in Aussie US dollar. So what I would do, I'm just going to bring it into a 30-minute chart to see if we can actually make a trade on this right now. So we have our 30-minute levels from analyst views as well. And you can see right away they're adjusted for your preference in time. So we have our analyst team. We update these several times a day. Right on my desk, we're doing it in about a half hour. We'll have a new update. Irregardless if we hit levels or not in intraday charts, it's important to know that we will update them many times a day, even if they haven't hit levels. We're always watching these currency pairs, especially the majors, and we're getting frequent updates sent to SwissQuote all the time. So here we have an interesting setup. I'm going to delete analyst views for now because we have our targets. We kind of have a scenario. We know there's major support here at 0.6805. But I like to have a clean chart. I just use these for reference. So let's just remove it quickly. And here I have an interesting setup. This is a full trend mode. So I'm not really concerned what the targets are right now because we're making new recent highs. But I think this is an opportunity where we've just broken above intraday highs. So this is, to me, a buy signal, buy market right away. Done. And easy stop here. Let's just drag it right down. I like to do maybe a little tick below the recent low. This nice red bearish candle bar here. And I'm going to leave it like that for now to see if we can catch a trend. Again, this is action based on the long-term view. So now we've got all our ducks in a row. We've had a long-term bullish view, short-term bullish breakout. So that is how we find interesting setups in Forex for sure, or any opportunity, any equity or commodity. So Aussie US dollar, let's jump into the Euro US dollar. And do I have it on my main page? Yes, I do. So we can just double click. All right, so here I've put in an example. I was looking at two other technical indicators that I use for Forex, money flow index and stochastics. I won't get into all the details of how we use them, but really I like to see, you know, money flow when we get to an oversold rating below 20 or even 10, that gives me an alert that maybe something's set up for a possible reversal, and stochastics the same way, right? So we got some extreme levels that we had, but nothing really here short term. Let's just go daily. And nothing really set up yet except for this massive breakout. So here we go. We have daily chart. We broke March 22nd high, this red line. And now we're actually moving on, probably most likely now, nothing really stopping it, to March highs, right around 1.149. So the long-term picture looks quite strong. We have momentum in play, stochastics above its 80 and embedded to the upside. Now, I have a lot of questions on these indicators alone. Is how do you use them? Do you use them as over, you know, overbought, oversold? I like to use them both ways. In this case here, you may think it's overbought, but we are still trending higher, and this can remain above 80 for quite some time with extreme money flow flowing into the pair above 80. That is a rare occurrence. It's strictly a momentum signal right now, how I view it. And no denying it, we have, again, US dollar has been pretty weak the last few days. Beautiful breakout on the euro US dollar. So long-term looks bullish. Let's bring it down to short-term. 30-minute chart, very similar to what we just saw in the Aussie. So here, definitely, why not try an opportunity here on a breakout? So we can do a quick buy. It's breaking out as we're talking. Let's bring a stop loss to this doji candle here that we had as reversal. See if you can find that as support. I'm just going to let it ride for now. So we've seen lots of opportunities today. Let's see what else we can find. So let's look at the cable. GBP, US dollar. What has been going on with this pair? Let's get to a longer term view. And let it load here. So we have pretty choppy price action. Again, looking quite strong in the last few days, but we've got some major resistance above us. So I'm more concerned before we hit that 200 period moving average, the 1.265-ish area, that double top we had. We need to break that first before it be extremely bullish long-term. I don't put too much weight into moving averages when we're in a consolidation. They're better for trend following. So I wouldn't use this as resistance. I would use key levels, clearly a double top, 1.2645-ish area in the cable. So let's just see if there's anything short-term. So I would say neutral to bullish midterm right now. Let's go intraday. And I'm just going to zoom in to most recent price action. Sometimes it gets carried away on the charts. Let's just zoom in daily and fix that. It's gone way out in our view. There we go. Still quite choppy. I'm going to try to zoom this in. And we are June 1st. Look at that rolling out of a consolidation. So, nice big rounded bottom. And we got strong momentum to the upside. This could be an opportunity to grab, you know, some pips to the key resistance area here at 1.2645-ish area. I don't really think it's a great opportunity yet because we've had such overextension past that 200 period moving average. So I'll probably leave some alone for now because, you know, the euro looks a lot better and there's better opportunities. So I would hold off on this pair for now until we break above that key resistance level on that daily chart. Red is crucial. All right, next up. Now, I'm just going to do a quick scan to see if anything has happened here. You can always check your trades again with the terminal. We can see that we're up money already today, about 36 bucks. And we made 49 right now on the Aussie US dollar. And let's just see if that's still moving in our favor. It's been a pretty quick trade, yet quite nice. So this is in full-on trend mode. We'll leave that alone for now. And we'll close up that terminal. And let's have a look at the US 30 spot index. So here we have US 30, right? I like to call this pretty much the Dow. Now it looks like we're trying to recover in the market. And let's go to daily. It's a little bit lagging here with the US 30 index, but here again, we got key resistance near that 200-day moving average and also those March highs right around here. So 27,080-ish area, I'd say. So we're trending higher, looking a lot better because this has been lagging behind the S&P and the NASDAQ. So for now, we are looking quite positive in the 30. You could even load in Nikkei. Here we have a huge breakout. This is quite the trend. The Nikkei 225 index just rocking higher, supported way above that 20 period moving average. That looks quite nice. So here, even if I, let's just try quick buy. Will it let me, there we go. Stop loss just below the recent lows. There we go. We'll let that ride and see if we can keep that trend going. A lot of people have fear for some reason of buying any kind of asset near its highs. But from my experience, assets making new record highs continue to do so for quite some time after. It is in momentum. And you should never be, you know, afraid of buying near highs. You know, that's been probably my most successful trades, you know, in my career, is catching the momentum and riding it until it no longer, you know, until it breaks a moving average or breaks trend. But here we're strictly trend following. No reason to not take something to ride this higher, because it can keep going to do so longer than you could expect. So we'll keep that one going. The other one we're looking at today, let's see if you have anything in oil, crude oil versus US dollar. Let's have a look at that. Let's go daily. So a huge rebound. This is better on a 30-minute chart. No surprise here, crude continues to tick higher. We got a nice trend in play. Nothing I'd really scream as a buy right now until we got near this trend line. That's the best possible setup scenario. Yeah, so we wait for a pullback. You can always enter in orders and wait for them to get there. You know, 28.45, right on the 20-minute average, but not a great setup right now. Nothing too confident. This could be quite volatile and choppy, so I'd rather watch that real time when we're trading it. And let's have a look if you have any other instant action in play. Let me close some windows down. US dollar yen, that's a huge move. We haven't really talked about that one yet. So daily, let's have a look at the chart. See, pretty different story. You're trying to break this consolidation. Again, you can always slide in analyst views if you're unsure of major levels. We do chart Forex on a weekly, a daily basis. So we have longer term views and intraday views. So this makes perfect sense here. We have a major resistance level at 109.35, according to our analyst views at Trading Central. So I would say, you know, more neutral to decline right now until we break this consolidation, and it can really draw it quite nicely here on a rectangle. This is what we're looking at daily. Major support at 106 and resistance at 109. So I know a lot of traders that love this type of scenario and will trade in and out of the consolidation. If you want some clarity with something we haven't talked about yet, is we can always add the adaptive convergence divergence. We haven't talked about it quite yet, but this is more like a beefed up moving average convergence divergence, or MACD. Again, I won't get into all the terms on here today, but this is really a faster MACD. It's more actionable for trading. That's how we use it. So, and we can add buy sell signals right on the chart. So I'm gonna add all the indicators right on to this pair. There's three parts to it. Here we have the raw smooth line, and then we can have the trigger. Let's give it a quick second. There we go. So, using all this data below, you don't have to understand how this indicator works, which is the beauty of the products we've made for Swiss Quote. Is what you can do is look at the signals it creates for you in a consolidation. So I'm just going to remove, now here I have almost every indicator except for candlesticks packed, but it gets quite cluttered. So I'm going to delete some so we can focus on what's important for now. indicators list, go into there anytime you want to remove some, click on analyst views. In this case, I'm going to delete it just to make it a little bit more easier to read. So we have an LX. What does LX mean? So we have an opportunity to exit long position, and it gives you the reason why below as to what happened. The arrow would be your opportunity to enter. So even though we're in a consolidation, this would have been a profitable setup if you followed this indicator where we had the one up arrow bar and it tells you why. So the adaptive filter is sloping upwards combined with both ACD lines, positive and sloping upwards. At this moment in time, we can go down and see that. I'll get my crosshairs here. So we have the up arrow, let's line it all right up. We have upwards sloping ACD slow and fast, and upwards sloping ACD raw and smooth. So here is a quick way to get an opportunity short term. We had a bunch of sales here as well, but these are always better in trending markets. But let's just go ahead and look at a intraday chart. All right, I'm gonna remove some of these. Close, and let's just go in. Also objects, don't necessarily need the rectangular, we'll delete that. And let's go into a 30-minute chart. Now, this is something that's, how would you trade something like this, right? So this is a huge upside today, massive break. There must be news. Again, I haven't been watching the market since I've been talking to you guys since the market opened, right when this webinar started. But what would you do here? You could try to be a counter trend trader and short this, or maybe get a continuation higher. So quite an interesting setup here. And this is pretty much a high risk. I probably wouldn't take any trade here at all until we broke below these major levels. So I would draw up major support, probably around 108.25 area, roughly. I'm just drawing these quickly. And this is how I go about my day in trading, is that right in the morning, if I see an opportunity, I'll start drawing my support resistance lines right away and wait for a breakout above or below before I make a trade. I'll be waiting for a quick alert. You can set up alerts on these, as once it ticks, you can go ahead and grab an opportunity to short or go long. This is how I actually trade the S&P all the time. Let's just see what's happening since we started this presentation. It looked quite bearish. Now we are slightly rebounding. But if you went to, say, a shorter term time frame, say 5 minutes, it does look quite bearish. I would do the same thing every day here. All I do is I put on my major levels I'm watching. This is probably the opening range, 306.2, and the high. And now I'd be waiting to see if we break either zone right now. So it's all about patience when you're trading intraday. That's why I have a lot of monitors running at all times to see if this breaks out. Let's see if this happens right now as we're talking. That'd be pretty cool if you get a breakout. And I think we might have been short this earlier today. Did we have it? No, we didn't have a trade on. And the market's going against us now. We still are up on the Aussie. Euro, US dollar is sliding. If you get a breakout here, I'd probably take a long on the US 500. And let's see what's happening with the euro US dollar, because we're running out of time. I want to make sure we get a real-time action in. What is going on? Yeah, we've come into resistance a little bit here. It's a little indecision. Not too worried right now. We got our stop. If you click it, we're out. So let's just see if you can get some momentum in the upside. I'm trying to find any other trades before we go today. I know we went through a lot of charts. This is kind of how I do my day. And anything else that I can pick up? US dollar. We haven't looked at the Swiss franc yet. That's probably one of the last ones. Let's have a look at the chart window on that pair. 30 minutes, not a lot of happening. Way too volatile. I would avoid this one for the day, but I'm always curious what the long-term trend looks like. Hey, we may have a chance to rebound. So we're in this consolidation. And maybe even this symmetrical triangle pattern forming, just like we had in the US dollar CAD. which is quite interesting. So I'm just going to draw this up. We have a declining trend line area of resistance. And let's go to the upside. Here we go. We have a quite an interesting breakdown of the US dollar CHF. This is a lot like the US dollar CAD. In fact, I'll show you right now, just slide it into the window. This is how it played out, and it's still getting lower. So we've had quite some volatility in Forex this morning as the market opens for the first hour. And it looks like the US dollar is going to continue its sell-off today. And this is what we're kind of expecting to play out for the CHF. Let's just see what happens though. So the way you trade this is if you get a rebound to test that upper trend line, that would be an opportunity to try to short with a stop loss right above the pattern. But I'm going to leave it there because there's a lot of charts and I can talk about these in markets forever. And I'll open up to the floor with some questions if Stefano has any he's looked at recently. And there was lots of information I've gone through today. But anything you have regarding trading, you know, trading strategy, you know, don't hesitate, fire away in the question box and I'll do my best to answer them for you. All right. I'm just going to open up the chat box now. We see you have some in here as to be able to see it. Now I see someone trading lots of Forex major pairs. And fortunately, I'm not sure if you can do options on this platform. I'm in Canada, keep that in mind. I don't trade through this platform, SwissQuote. So I have different listed options in North America, but I'm sure Stefano may be able to answer that for you.
Yes, Gary, I asked where in the chat that with us it is possible to trade the Forex options and also option listed on the exchange. So we also have a webinar on swissquote.com/webinars. This is the link, and then you have to click on on-demand section, and you can access immediately to the recording of different webinars where we explain what is a Forex options, how a call or put works. So yes, we do have.
Excellent.
And then there were some questions about some indicators like MACD or RSI, but then you show the indicators that Central offers. So I think
it's perfect. Yeah, so that one, just to elaborate, because I get a lot of questions on what do we use mainly at Trading Central, and I would say the most would be MACD and RSI. Because we're trend following, just to keep that in mind, we use RSI the most, I would say. And then the ACD we've developed to kind of give you a more actionable intraday trading option for SwissQuote. So yes, good question there. Yeah, I'm scanning through them. I have a slow PC at home right now, so bear with me. But if Stefano, if you see any, just let me know.
Yeah, I think more or less you already answered to most of the questions during the presentation.
Good.
I also attached the PDF of the presentation in GoToWebinar so everybody can download them.
Excellent. Okay. Yeah, so someone had a question again, adaptive candlesticks, are they equal with engulfing doji? Yes, we use only the reversal patterns. There's no list out there as to which ones we're using because it's all kind of our own proprietary embedded into this into the code. But really, it's the major reversals, which would be hammers, dojis, engulfing patterns, three strike reversals. Very basic ones that we've tested that work the most and give us the best results, because there is tons. I mean, there's tons of books out there. You can spend, you know, a whole career just focusing on candlesticks, and we just focus on the ones that have actually made us money the most and helped us with our direction. So again, good question there, but it'd be the major reversals, and like you said, engulfing doji. and on any time frame, really any frequency. So keep in mind, always this three indicator packs works on any chart frame, right? Could be daily, intraday, and weekly. We also provide weekly analysis with our analyst views like you saw here on the NASDAQ. So if I go ahead and change it to a longer term view, right, you're going to get an update right away on the weekly pivots. All right, so just to point that out in case I missed it, we have targets for the longest term view we have available, which is quite helpful. Yes. Anything else we see there, Stefano, that I might have missed?
No, I think it's fine. So thank you, Gary.
Excellent.
I think you already explained everything. So you also place different trades. So thank you very much for this very engaging session. I love it.
Excellent. And, me too. Excellent. Yeah, it's good fun. Yeah, thank you.
The calendar for the next schedule with you. So everybody can visit the swissquote.com/webinars and register already to the next webinars in case you need. And you also explain how to use Trading Central, how to install. So it's perfect. I just want to remember that I said that at the beginning of the presentation, but please remember that the plugin of Trading Central works on MT4 and MT5 with a live account with a balance of at least 1,000 Swiss franc or equivalent. So we are available for all the questions that you have. In case you can visit swissquote.com, we also have a chat available. So thank you very much, Gary, for this session. And thank you all. Have a good day. Take care.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks a lot. Take care. Happy trading.